Hello everyone, my name is Tanya Trindade. I am an aerospace engineer and I've always loved surfing. I'm from Carcavelos. I grew up here. I was born in DRC. I will talk to you about DRC. It's the Democratic Republic of Congo. My parents live in DRC for 42 years. And when I was 5 years old, I came to Portugal because there was a big war. And my parents left me here with my grandparents. When my parents left, my mom was crying and asked my grandmother, "What are you going to do with her and my older sister?" And my grandmother said, "I will put her doing everything. So she will study hard, she will do sports, she will play the piano." So I started playing the piano. I was 5 years old, and I finished also the piano course at Instituto Gregorian de Lisboa. Before going on, I stutter a lot, so let's start rehumanizing from here to be empathy, dude, and have a little patience. So I started working here in Portugal, so I finished my degree and started in an airline, Portuguese airline, as a maintenance engineer. And then I worked in a company leading the satellite systems and unmanned air systems. But one day I was fulfilling my duties, but I felt I was just one more in the office. I've always liked challenges. If I had to choose between a small wave or a big wave, I would go always to the big wave. So, and my parents are adventurous, are very generous, and they have always taught me that I could do everything in my life. If I wanted to be an astronaut, I could be. So everything was possible. That's a point that I wanted to tell you, that if we talk about dreams come true to early children, dreams can be true. And, well, I was saying that I was in my office and I wanted to do something more. I told my then boyfriend, "Do you want to come and live with me in Congo?" He looked at me with an amazement. "You are always surprising me. To Congo." "Yes, to Congo. It's very nice there." So he went with me, and today my then boyfriend is my husband, and he's my better half that helps me do everything I dream and I put into practice. We start working in a company of forestry, sustainable management of forestry, and then it turned into a conservation forestry company, and I assumed the position of environment, social and governance, the chief of ESG. And one of the elements of the corporate social responsibility of the company is a hospital. So we went to live in a province called Maindombe. Maindombe is 300 kilometers away from Kinshasa, the capital. And when we got there, we went to live in a village with a huge forests around. So if you know, rainforest in DRC, it's the second largest forest in the world after Amazon, but it has been considered since COP27 last year the first stock reservoir, the largest reservoir of carbon in the world. As you can see, well, when you, I'm going back one image, it's very important. When you think about forests and climate change and protecting environment, I think most of the people think about the trees and the wildlife. But one thing that is very important that live inside the forest are people. That we have indigenous peoples and we have people, communities. So, and as you can see, the rate of children is very high in province and in DRC. One thing that is very important for you to know, DRC has 155 million hectares of forest, and the whole country, 67%, it's the land, the total land, the 67% of the total land area it's covered by forests, so it's huge. This is the, I'm showing you the images of the place we went to live. When I talk about people, women have a really important role in forests. They are the ones who carry out the wood to do energy and food too. So I was telling you one part of the company. The company has a really important role in social part. So there is a hospital in Mindombe province where I lived, which makes part of the CSR of the company. And I had one of my duties was to manage this hospital. But I could not be indifferent of what I saw. For the first time in my life, I saw children dying in my arms. One child, two, three, many. And it was a huge shock. We live here, I've always lived here, I've never seen something like this. So I had to do something personal besides my responsibility as a company, and I tried to communicate with these children from the malnutrition center. So, you know NGO AMI, Assistência Médica Internacional, founded this project in the hospital in 2007. And since then, this project is free for all the population of the DRC. And four out of 10 children suffers from malnutrition in DRC. It's very high. When you think about malnutrition, maybe you think about children very thin and like you see most on the television. But in the sub-Saharan Africa, the physical effects are different. The skin loses its color. The abdomen and feet swell. And they start with many wounds in the skin. Maybe if you look at the child that is on your left, you would say that it's a normal child. But if you look at her feet, they are very swollen. So this is malnutrition. And so before she was like that, and after we could say, well, I'm showing you only three examples. As the host said, we have saved more than 6,500 children in this project, and we continue to do it for free. Thank you. So this is a very, I'm sorry of the quality of the photo, but these are the photos that they sent me. So, and this is another example of malnutrition before and after. And it's a very impressive thing that fulfills our soul every day when we see the results after. So, I was telling you I wanted to communicate better with these children. As I told you at the beginning, I studied the piano, I did the conservatory here in Lisbon, and I've always been very involved to music. Before going to aerospace engineering at the Instituto Superior Técnico, my dream was to do a music conductor. But my family, even my grandparents, are very strict, and they said, you want to do what? Music? No. You have to study, you don't want to study. So you go to engineering. But music always stayed with me, and I did it besides my working. And so I started, as I could not speak Lingala, it's one of the languages in DRC, I started singing with the children. And at the beginning, it was very hard because I had no reaction from them, and I thought they didn't even like what I was doing. So I started learning Lingala, the language, and started singing songs in Lingala to attract children to be more close of their culture. One thing very important when you change completely your life, you have to look ahead and try to understand the other culture. That empathy is really the key to make peace and to be okay everywhere we go. So so we start little by little. At the beginning, well, with malnutrition, I'm seeing my With malnutrition, children lose a lot our cognitive power, so they cannot be concentrated, they cannot memorize anything. But I felt with music, they started memorizing lyrics from songs, starting dancing with the choreographies, and Harvard Medicine School attests that music has a really good effect on health. So medical outcomes increases a lot with music, even to mental health, to many diseases. So there are scientific studies that are going the same way as my experience. I didn't know that when I started. So children started singing so well that I put, well, here you can see it is my oldest daughter with me. So are the children who were healed from malnutrition. They started singing, and step by step, they went out to the hospital, and we opened a music school, a free music school, to every child, because every day, every Saturday, I taught music Saturdays afternoons, because it was the only time I didn't work. And all at the beginning, these children were completely neglected and put apart from the society. But at rehearsals day, all children from the village were outside the hospital and say, I want to sing also with these children. So I was obliged to open a school outside the hospital, and every child from the village came, but the priority was given to children who were healed. And children and teenagers that were healed had to go at least 2 times at the hospital singing with those that are healed to give them hope. So I started, the mortality rate started decreasing a lot, because one of the things I saw, of course, it was the music was always besides the medical treatment. So they have medical treatment, but they have music also at the same time. And the rate of abandon of the project started also decreasing, because the treatment is so tough that most of the children and their parents go away. Well, now I have to tell about Georgetown. In 2019, I was contacted by the producer of Georgetown, but I didn't believe it was real, because I was a huge fan of Georgetown since I was a child. And he contacted me at the Banda Congo official page, and I didn't believe it was true. I didn't answer. And the producer, 1 week after, said, you don't answer our question. We want to go to DRC. Georgetown is doing her world tour, and one of the countries missing is the DRC. Why don't you answer? I didn't believe it was true. So one thing I have to pass message, mainly to the youth and teenagers that can be here, and young people, is that never underestimate yourself. Always believe you can do more, and if you don't give up, you will do it wherever you want. So Georgetown came to Kinshasa, and she proposed to sing with these children. We prepared everything, and I will never forget the concert. It was an energy I had never seen. And at the end, she said, listen, Tanya, I never imagined I could see children that have this past and have performed in this way with an energy and smiling, and it was the best performance of my life in the world tour. So I was very, yeah. So I think now there is a little surprise.
Hello, everyone. I'm Joss Stone. I so wish that I was there tonight with Tanya. What she does with Banda Congo is something that you would not believe. I went out to the Congo, and I met with Tanya and Banda Congo, all of these beautiful kids, and I learned about what she does for them, how she pulled them out of a pretty meek, disastrous position and put them in a place where they are happy, they are fed, they are educated. I mean, really, what's better than that? We all love our kids. All over the world, everybody loves their kids, but sometimes we can't provide for them. And people like Tanya allows that to happen. They help that happen. It's a beautiful thing. Some of these kids had illnesses. Some of them just had like a really, really bad, they got a bad deal on life. And she helped them. And she continues to help them. Sometimes it's a thankless job. And she continues to do it. It is so, so gorgeous. And the funny thing is, when I go and I visit charities a lot, and I see beautiful people doing beautiful things often. And music is often involved, and it's always like fun. Music brings fun. It brings brightness and lightness into the room, so it makes people smile. And if you can do that for a kid, then you're doing well. But Tanya does something a little bit extra. She makes it really, really good. Like, these kids, they're not just like banging on things and making noises just for a laugh. Oh, no, no, no. They are good. Like, they played a concert, basically, and I got a chance to stand by the side of the stage and watch it. And I got a chance to sing with them, which was amazing. But my goodness me, they are like professionally good. So well done, Tanya. Well done for keeping your standard high musically. That's great. And really well done for just helping human beings. It's a beautiful thing. And I'm really glad that I was able to be part of it, even if it was just for 1 minute. It was so, so special. So yeah, good luck with it. Keep doing it, girl. Bye.
Thank you. Well, I didn't expect this video. It was a surprise from Laurinda. Thank you very much. And well, today, I don't live in Mindombe anymore. For 4 years, I am Kinshasa. My children also grew up, so they have to have education too in Kinshasa. And also my duties led me to go to the capital. Sorry? I'm very touched, yeah. Okay. So, let me tell you one thing I will show you the movie and I will finish here. I think music is a very important tool to humanize and to do better things. So, never underestimate yourself. Thank you very much.
Hercule. Parce que lui, il est star. Moi aussi, je deviens star comme lui.
Ce petit film veut montrer comment la musique a aidé et peut continuer à aider les enfants de la province du Mindombe. Tout a commencé dans un centre de nutrition privé à l'hôpital général de référence de Nyoki. Une école de musique gratuite a été créée, ouverte à tous les enfants. Les enfants venant des centres de nutrition y ont toujours priorité.
Pas comme ça changerait ma vie.
And earlier, I was very honored to look at the testimony of Just Sound. But now, as I am a lucky girl, I am very honored to call Mário Lajinha, the greatest Portuguese pianist, to play with me one of the most popular songs, original songs from Bana Congo. Obrigada.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So, when I heard from Aurinda from this incredible project, I will stutter too. So, so we are. I was overwhelmed with all this, as you probably you are and you should, incredible. So, but it's incredible coincidence that I came from Panama, where I was invited to do a master class in a small school in a small village called Porto Belo, and. The guy that created that school is called Rui Diniz, and it's Portuguese, actually from Carcavelos, and he's living there for 12 years, and he changed that village. It's incredible. In a way that now they want him to be the president of the town. So it's incredible, but it was really touching. The school is incredible, so I would like to show you just 1 minute from the project, and then I say something more.
Una vieja me dio un coco para que se lo pelara. Después que se lo bote, se le mete el diablo a esa mujer que quiere su
Attraverso il Valle di Portobelo ha desempeñado un papel de importancia creciente en el desarrollo socioeconómico de la población portobelenha, a través del arte, la cultura y la sostenibilidad. Nuestro modelo se fundamenta en la recuperación y puesta en valor de la cultura afrocaribeña y del cimarronaje, elementos de empoderamiento esenciales y distintivos de la identidad cultural portobelenha. Al final, la Fundación Bahía de Portobelo está comprometida en mejorar la calidad de vida de la comunidad con programas que buscan el progreso a través de la cultura.
Actualmente contamos con tres programas: la Escuelita del Ritmo, el Taller Portobelo, Taller de Arte Congo, y la Casa de la Cultura Congo. La Escuelita del
Ritmo es la escuela. I could see and feel how the music became so important to the community, and I was really touched, and I thought one important thing is that the biggest influence from their music is from Congo, so it's from Congo, Yeah, the music and the diversity in music, it has a role so big to create bridges in between people, and it's always a step in the direction of peace, and we need peace. Now I will play just one song that I wrote, and it was with the influence from the Choro from Brazil. So I hope you enjoy.